fucking tired, yeah. So, what you say? Feeling good, I'm feeling great.
What it do, YouTube? My name is Bear Witness. Welcome back to the channel. Now, today's video, we have some tips on Anthem. Now, I want to go ahead and say disclaimer right here, because I want everybody to realize that some of you might have caught on to these things a little bit early. Some of this might not be news to you. For you guys, enjoy the gameplay in the background, and there you go. But let's remember that a lot of people haven't played it yet. A lot of people don't catch on to things as easy as other people. So we're just gonna go ahead and run down some tips so everybody can be on the same skill level. So when we're doing those hard level raids and things like that, strongholds, whatever you wanna call them, everybody's on the same page. Everybody's at least got the basics down. Everybody knows, you know, what they should know to be able to play the game and not be, you know, the frustrating dude that goes down every 5 seconds. So with that, all of that being said, guys, I want to quickly jump into something. I am doing a giveaway, so if you guys are interested in a free copy of Anthem, make sure you guys click that link in the description below so you guys can get all signed up for all that. And with all that being said, guys, let's talk about it. First things first, we're going to talk about flight mechanics. Now, flight mechanics are somewhat difficult to get used to. I've heard that they're a lot more difficult on PC, so yeah. But to stay in the air a long time, what I mean by difficult to use is that sometimes you get carried away, and because it's new, it's kind of a new flight mechanic that a lot of games haven't done before, so it can get easy to burn out. But the more time you spend on the ground and burning out, the more vulnerable you are, because you can't get out of situations and things like that. So we want to keep you guys able to have your cooldowns as much as possible. Now, when it is raining inside of the game, it automatically adds a cooldown. Now, your armor attaches to a lot of elements, so we won't talk about that in the current moment. But what we are going to talk about right now is that rain, water, anything like that, all of it cools down your armor, things like that. So that's the first tip that we're going to go ahead and give you guys. If you skim across like the water, like, because there's usually tons of water in the game, if you skim across it, it usually cools down your suit. Rain cools down your suit. And something that a lot of people might not have known is that when you dive straight down, it cools down your suit too. So mixing all of those things in together, you know, maybe, you know, if you have to go long distances, staying low towards the water and stuff like that, that'll help out, you know. And like I said, if you are in a situation where you're not next to water, diving straight down should cool down your suit and things like that. So that's something that I thought was really cool that I actually did not see in my first week, which is why I'm kind of telling you guys about it now. But further on with that, guys, I want to go ahead and mention that if there is a situation in which you're on fire, that immediately makes it so where you can't actually take off, where you can't take flight. So make sure that you guys understand that, and make sure that you guys are running to cover, because, you know, getting caught out in the open in the wrong stronghold or situation, that is how you get messed up very, very, very quickly. So that's one thing I wanted to go ahead and talk to you guys about. So next up, we have primers and detonators. Now, these are going to be their ways of, and I was going to make a whole nother video on this, but I thought, why not just make it a part of the tips and tricks video. I'll put up a diagram on the side of the screen as I'm saying this. But primers and detonators. Now, primers are the types of abilities that allow your target to be coated in lightning. Some of them, you know, coat them in lightning, some of them coat them in acid and things like that. But they're things that, you know, create an effect to which, when activated by a detonator, it makes a giant explosion. So, you know, you can mix things like acid and lightning. Those are a combo that I use quite frequently. So remember that when you're picking your abilities to in any situation, you kind of want to, especially if you're playing by yourself, if you want to just make things easier on yourself, you want to pick primers and detonators if you at all can. And the only class that I don't think has those are, you know, I haven't really played a lot with those, but from what I've seen in the early game, I know that the Ranger has a detonator. I don't think that the Interceptor has either, but like I said, I haven't experienced those classes in at full length. So if they do, make sure you guys leave that in the comment section below to help out anybody that's watching this video. Now, next up, we have just a couple of general tips that you guys can use. Now, one thing that I have noticed that I want to address, and this does come as a tip, but it doesn't at the same time. A lot of the beginner players are like, they take away the Ranger and they're like, oh, this is kind of boring. I urge you to level up, and you guys will see that there is a lot more fun things to be done with a lot of the other characters, as well as the Ranger can become very fun in itself once you unlock Bulwark Point, his abilities, and the second weapon. And this is strictly going by beginning players, like players that just got into the game. So that's just a quick, you know, PSA to them, quick thing that I wanted to tell you guys. And the last two are kind of things that I just thought should be talked about based on the fact that, you know, a lot of players are complaining about these situations. So this is not as much tips at this current point, but more of like there it is tips in a way. So a lot of people say, oh, why is my Colossus not tanky? Now, this is something I want to address. A quick tip for you guys is that you guys want to switch up your components. If you can get higher shield components, I think there's a health component, and things like that, you're able to add on. And if you can also couple that with using your shield effectively, you know, there's a lot of tankiness that to be had there. So you can use your shield by pressing B on Xbox or circle on PlayStation. This is a thing that, you know, a lot of people just kind of don't know about. They kind of stick to the bare bones. Like, the beta pushed us into a situation where we did not learn any of the tutorials. So this is kind of like a, you know, some people don't even know about it. Like, I was playing with a gentleman earlier who didn't even know he had a shield, and he was playing a Colossus, and he was like literally upset because he was playing the tankiest build that we'd seen. And, you know, he was spongy. He was spongy as shit because he didn't know how to use it appropriately. So this is kind of a tip on how to use Colossus in a way. And I hope that that's appreciated in this, because, you know, as we don't have that much access to the game, it's kind of hard to put out tips, but I'm kind of trying to help everywhere that I can. So there's that too. Also, for you storm mains out there, I want you guys to know that if you guys are spending more time on the ground than you guys are in the air, then you're playing your class wrong. I say that because myself as a storm main was doing this wrong. You need to be in the air as much as possible, hovering specifically, because one, you're hovering, from what I can see, actually doesn't take up your energy from what I've seen. Now, I might be wrong on this, but I play tested it quite a bit, and I don't know if it's a glitch in the game or if that's something that's going to be in the final game. But as far as I know, you can stay in the air, at least if not forever or hover forever, you can hover for a very long amount of time. In fact, longer than any other javelin in the game. So you want to be doing this because it makes your shield double, like it doubles your shield strength. So if, you know, being one of the lighter armor classes, I definitely think that you guys should be doing this. And it also provides a good spot in the battlefield for you to release all of your abilities and helping out all of your teammates in situations that you should. Also, you're not supposed to directly be in the fight. In fact, if you are in the fight up front, it's kind of a bad place for you to be, because you're not able to kind of blanket the battlefield with your DPS, and you're kind of in a weird situation. What I like to do personally is I like to equip my highest level marksman rifle and my highest level sniper rifle. I use my sniper rifle more than most, and then I use my marksman rifle if things get a little hairy with people up close to me. So with all of that being said, guys, that's probably your best way of using those. And that's gonna be like most of my video. This is gonna be the end of it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this, and these tips kind of gave you guys a little bit of an extra oomph to, you know, learn your builds a little bit more, and hopefully you guys will be able to be more effective inside of big things like the Tyra Mine. If you guys are able to play that this weekend, because I have not been able to fucking play it, because everything happens. Either my game crashes, either fucking, you know, my game crashes, or people leave, or things like that. So I haven't been able to complete Tyra Mine, but hopefully this will help you guys complete Tyra Mine. And if you guys enjoyed this video, you guys already know what to do. I ain't even gotta say it, but I'm gonna say it anyways. Leave a like down below, click that bell and that sub button so you guys can be notified on all of my future Anthem videos. And make sure you guys are telling your friends, because this is one of the best places to get a free copy of Anthem. So if you guys are excited as I am, then make sure you guys are spamming that up in the comment section below. Hype for Anthem. And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace. I'm out of here.